In meditation, we ask God what we should do about each specific matter. Period. And the next sentence is so powerful and so important because it runs all the way through our entire prayer and meditation life. The right answer will come if we want it. Which means quite simply, if I have decided that Mary Sue Luann, whatever her name is that she's God-given, that God wants this absolutely, and I'm going to have it come hell or high water, which hell is probably right around the corner when I do this. I'm going to convince myself that this is God's will for me, and I'm going to go to my sponsor and I'm going to say, I know this is God's will for me. And my sponsor says, well, you better meditate about it, hadn't you? And so now I'm meditating. You can see me meditating. But I'm not going to accept any answer except the one I want. God better say, oh, yeah, my boy. That's my will for you. Go get it, man. This is really... I don't get that answer. I reject it. I might even try several times to see if the answer comes up different next. Oh, man. Did I say something about us really being saner than anybody else out there? Maybe I better take that back. No, I still believe that. And it's because we have this, guys. It's because we get to do this, because we are taught and instructed to do it, and because when we do it, it works, and because when it works, we get faith. And then we say, God, I trust you. I'm going to turn to you and ask you, what do you want me to do? And when we're meditating, the key to meditation is to be willing to accept the answer no matter what it may be. Down at the bottom of the page, God alone can judge our sex situation. Wow, how important is that? You know... Around here, there are always a certain number of vultures who are making decisions and making judgments about everybody else. And they especially circle and peck at the weak members of the herd, you know. The ones that make themselves vulnerable or falter. You find them circling. It's too bad. If you're a sponsor, you try your best to protect your little pigeons from this. But there are some people who are able to stick around here for a while doing unspeakable things. But keep in mind that alcoholism is a self-cleaning oven. Sooner or later, they're gone. But making judgments about other people, where in the hell do we get the idea that we have a right to do that? We don't judge anyone else's sex situation. Counsel with others, it says, is often desirable, but we let God be the final judge, period. Now, there are all kinds of and shapes and forms of sexuality floating around, some of which we may not agree with. Maybe we've got religious convictions. Tough. That's just tough. That has every place in the church and no place in here. Remember what they said back in the American Revolution, when those guys were signing the Declaration of Independence, that we must all hang together, or assuredly we will all hang separately. The unity of our fellowship is the foundation stone of our own personal recovery, and without it, we perish. We do not make judgments. Whatever your private judgment may be, that's fine, and anything which is private with you and is not expressed or bandied about is fine. We all get to have that. That is never taken away from us. But we do not express nor act upon these judgments because we have no right to do so. We realize that some people are as fanatical about sex as others are loose. We avoid hysterical thinking or advice. This paragraph is really, really, really interesting and very important, and I want to tell you that it's going to carry forward to our 11th step. What we learn here is what we will carry forward into our 11th step. Let's see what it is. We have our ideal for how we wish to live our future sex life. Suppose we fall short of the chosen ideal and stumble. Does this mean we're going to get drunk? Some people tell us so, but this is only a half-truth. It depends on us and on our motives. Aha! Motives is raising its ugly head right here, isn't it? And we're going to hear more and more and more about motive as we go. When you start taking a PhD in recovery up around the 11th step, motive is going to be very important. Because we're going to find out that we can do the right thing for the wrong motive and be just as wrong as if we did the wrong thing. And so we're going to be watching our motives all the way through.